This week we explore three tiki-fied riffs on the ultra-classic The Last Word. Stick around. So if you've been following the show, you probably recall that we've made several riffs on popular tiki and rum cocktail classics, such as the Army-Navy Grog based on the Navy Grog, Mariner's Ghost based on the Ancient Mariner, and the Honey Honey and the Melikaliki Maka Mai Tai based on, well, the Mai Tai. But today we wanted to explore a non-tiki cocktail that can be riffed into the
Tropical Galaxy,
an ultra-classic The Last Word. So the original Last Word goes all the way back to the Prohibition era, right around the 1920s, served at the Detroit Athletic Club bar. But thanks to Prohibition stunting its popularity, by the end of the century, the drink had basically become entirely forgotten.
Until...
it was rediscovered in 2004 by Murray Stenson at the Zigzag Cafe in Seattle, and since then has reclaimed its popularity the whole world over. So why is this drink so popular again? Well, it's an equal parts recipe, which is really good at showcasing the individual ingredients. It has green chartreuse, which is really in style right now.
And very expensive.
And in its simplicity, it's really easy to swap out that spirit base and riff it into new recipes. Now, the Last Word has been riffed so many times in virtually every spirit direction that it ought to really be called the Encyclopedia. But since we're rum lovers here, today we want to focus on three unique riffs that tiki it up a bit. You might even think of it as a trilogy. Up first is the Wordsmith, created by cocktail aficionado Chuck Taggart, which simply swaps out the gin portion with Smith and Cross.
Hence the name.
Making the recipe consists of lime juice, marascino liqueur, green chartreuse, and of course, navy-proof Jamaican gold rum. All right, let's jump in. Start with that 3/4 ounce of lime juice. 3/4 ounce of marascino liqueur using Luxardo. 3/4 ounce of green chartreuse. And finally, 3/4 ounce of our gold Jamaican rum, Smith and Cross. All right, let's pour this into our shaker. I'm gonna toss in several ice cubes for shaking to chill, agitate, and incorporate. Shake for about 15 seconds. Also, just sounds cool. As is Last Word tradition, we're gonna serve this in a chilled coupe glass served up. Now we're gonna double strain this in. The double strain is just to catch any of the ice chips that may have come loose during the shake. All right, there it is, the Wordsmith. We're gonna hold on to this and compare all three at the end. Next up, there's the Last Bird, originally by Andrew Zakim, which attempts to riff a last word into a jungle bird. What we've done is taken Andrew's recipe and modified it a little bit to be closer to a last word riff formula, swapping that gin for a pineapple rum and the marascino for Campari, bringing the final lineup to lime, green chartreuse, Campari, and a pineapple rum. All right, let's get started with that 3/4 ounce of lime. Let's do 3/4 ounce of Campari, 3/4 ounce of the green chartreuse, and 3/4 ounce of a pineapple rum. We're going to use Plantations Diggins. Let's pour this into our shaker. Shake with a couple ice cubes to chill, incorporate, and agitate. Shake for about 15 seconds. Also just sounds cool. Let's grab our chilled coupe glass here. And once again, we will double strain it in. Oh yeah, look at that jungle bird color. There it is, the Last Bird. Now on to the final. So finally, there's the Last Resort, a cleverly named tropical take by bartender John Lewis from Pa D in Portland, Oregon, who subs out the marascino liqueur for banana liqueur and cognac and uses a pineapple-infused gin, and also tosses in a spritz of mezcal, bringing the final ingredient lineup to lime, cognac, green chartreuse, banana liqueur, pineapple-infused gin, and the mezcal spritz. Now for that pineapple-infused gin, we simply took Leopold's gin, put it in a mason jar and used an equal volume amount of pineapple slices and rind and let it infuse for several days. All right, let's start with our 3/4 ounce of lime juice, 1/2 ounce of banana liqueur, we're gonna use Gifford, or Giffard, whatever you prefer. 1/4 ounce of cognac. We're actually going to use Remy Martin. 3/4 ounce of our green chartreuse. And 3/4 ounce of our pineapple infused gin. All right, let's toss it into our shaker. Add the ice cubes to chill, agitate, and incorporate. Shake for about 15 seconds. Also just sounds cool. Right. Once again, I'm gonna strain into our chilled coupe glass, double strained. All right, now that we've strained it in, let's do that mezcal spritz. Now it says for several spritzes, so we're really gonna lay it on. All right, there it is, the last resort. Now let's get them all back and compare. All right, let's start with the Wordsmith. Interesting, so in my opinion, this one will probably taste the most like a last word. You get that green chartreuse and the marascino really coming through, really pairing together as usual. And then you kind of get that gold Jamaican navy proof stuff right at the very end on the nose, like on the exhale. All right, now that last bird, let's check it out. Wow, so something that I'm learning from this is that the marascino can be a very overpowering ingredient. It's really pairing together with that Campari, and the two of them together are punching through in a big way. It's kind of muting the pineapple rum a little bit, but overall, still very good cocktail. All right, now the last resort. It's funny, you get that banana and mezcal fighting with each other right on the nose. All right, so that marascino has finally met its match with that banana liqueur, which really comes to the forefront. And also the citrus infused into that gin really pairs well with the lime, but it's not too citrus forward. It's actually fairly mellow. And the mezcal doesn't really interfere with the flavor too much, just kind of sits on the nose on top. So there you go. 3 riffs of the classic last word transported into the tropical cocktail galaxy. Whether you want something more subtle with the Wordsmith or a bit punchier with the last resort, all 3 of these are great to try.
There is no try.
So let us know in the comments below if you end up making any of these riffs at home, and let us know which one your favorite might be. And as always, please consider giving us a like and subscribe so you don't miss out on future cocktail recipes and tiki adventures. Until then, cheers.
Precious.